and my fellow friends. Today, the year 8A is going to perform a play called The Merchant of Venice by William Shakespeare. This play is about the rivalry between the rich merchant Antonio and the Jewish moneylender Shylock. Antonio charges no interest, while Shylock charges a high interest. So, more people go to Antonio, and Shylock hates it. Rosario wants to borrow money from Antonio to woo a beautiful lady named Portia. So Antonio is so sure his ships will come back really with wealth, agreeing to lend Rosario 3,000 ducats. However, he does not have the money, and later, Rosario went to beautiful Portia, but all of Antonio's ships sink during the journey. Antonio is unable to pay back the money, and Shylock gets him arrested. Portia, who is not only beautiful but intelligent, goes to court dressed as a gentleman lawyer to fight the case against Shylock. This is the court scene in which Shylock is about to take his penalty, a pound of Antonio's flesh, and Graciano, his best friend, is also present. So please, sit back and enjoy.
Don't bother arguing with the Jew. You might as well go stand on the beach and and ask the ocean to get smaller. You might as well ask the wolf why it killed lamb and made its mother cry. You might as well go tell the vikings on the mountains to stop waving their treetops when the storm blows through them. You might as well try the impossible rather than try soft with Jewish heart. It's the hardest thing imaginable. Therefore, I beg you, please don't look for other ways to kill him. Just let me receive my punishment and let you take his penalty.
Instead of your 3,000 devils, you have 6,000.
If you offered me 6 times that, I wouldn't accept it. I will choose to take my penalty.
How can you ever hope to risk more yourself when you don't give any now?
I don't have to be afraid of your judgment. I stand here with the law on my side. Many of you own slaves, which like your donkeys and dogs and mules, you used to perform awful jobs just because you bought them. Should I say, set them free, let them marry your children? Why are you making them work so hard? Let their beds be as soft as you. Let them eat the same food as you. No, you'd answer, the slaves are ours, and that's just how I'm answering you. That piece of flesh that I bought from him was very expensive. I want it, and I'm going to get it. If you refuse me, the laws of Venice have no validity. So answer me, will I get it?
I have the authority to split this court, unless Venarius of Slaves is a legal expert by Centaur to act as judge and help settle this matter.
My lord, I must see that you can fight with Valerian's letters. Please come so far.
Bring up the letters. Call the messenger in.
Cheer up, Antonio. Keep up your courage, man. I'm giving you my flesh, my blood, my bones for you.
Like the one sick sheep in the flock, the one that deserves to die. The weakest root drops to the ground first, so let me drop. Bassanio, the best thing you can do right now is to keep on living and write an epitaph for my gravestone.
Yes, sir. Which one is the richest, and which one is the truth?
Sorry. The case is most unusual. The Venetian law is open to the city. He has a claim on it, correct?
Yes. So it stays.
Do you acknowledge the contract?
Yes, I do.
Then the Jew should be arrested.
What? Why should I do that? Tell me.
No one shows mercy because he has to. It just happens, the way gentle rain drops to the ground. Mercy is a double blessing. It blesses the one who gives it and the one who receives it. It's strongest in the strongest people. It looks better in a king than his own crown looks on him. The king's scepter represents his earthly power, the symbol of majesty, the focus of royal authority. But mercy is higher than the scepter. It's a throne in the hearts of kings, a quality of God himself. Kingly power seems most like God's power when a king mixes his mercy with justice. So although justice is your plea, consider this. Justice won't save our souls. We pray for mercy, and the same prayer teaches us to show mercy towards as well. I told you this to make a given this case. If you pursue it, the Street Court of Venice will need to carry out a sentence against a merchant there.
I take full responsibility for all my decisions. I want the law, the penalty, and the fulfillment of my contract.
Can't you give back the money?
Yes, I have it ready, and I've quartered them. Is that not enough? I'll sign a contract to pay 10 times the bunch. I'll give you my flesh, my blood, my bones. If that's not enough, you're just evil and malicious. I will. Just this once. You shall follow me to do a great right by doing a little wrong. No, let this devil get over.
That can't happen. There is no power in Venice that can change an established decree. The change will be recorded as a precedent, and many valuable decisions will result. That cannot happen.
Oh, Daniel has come to judge me. Yes, Daniel. Oh, wise young judge, I honor you.
Please, let me review the contract.
Here it is, judge.
Shylock, they're offering you 3 times the money that you lent.
But I made an oath in heaven. Should I perjure my soul by disobeying it? No, not for all of Venice.
The money wasn't paid back, and so the jewel may lawfully claim a pound of flesh nearest the merchant's heart. But please, have mercy. Take 3 times your money. Tell me to tear up this contract.
I'll tear it up when it's paid. You seem like a good judge. You know the law. Your explanation can make sense. I urge you to deliver your verdict. I swear that nothing anyone can say will change my mind. I'm sticking with the contract.
I beg the court to deliver the verdict.
Well then, here's it. You must prepare yourself for the man.
Yes, what a wise judge. Come on, get ready.
The law fully authorizes the penalty, which you have to pay according to the contract.
What an upright judge. You're so much older than you look.
So bare your chest.
Yes, his chest. That's what the contract says, doesn't it? Nearest his heart. Those are the very words.
Yes. Is there a scale here to see the flesh?
Yes, I have it ready.
Please go to the standby and bind his wounds, Shadow, so he doesn't bleed to death.
Is that called for in the contract?
Not explicitly, but so what? It would appear for you to be charitable.
It's not in the contract. I can't find it.
You, merchant, do you have anything that you wish to say?
Not much. I'm ready to wait. Give me your hand, son. Don't be sad that this happened because of you. Because Lady Luck is nicer to me than usual. Usually, she would make the unhappy man live on after losing all his wealth to spend his whole day in poverty. Send your honorable wife my greetings and tell her how I died. Speak well of me after I'm dead, and when the tears up, ask her to judge whether Bassanio had a friend. Be sad only at the fact that you'll lose your friend. Your friend doesn't regret that he paid your debt. As the Jew, because he's enough, I'll pay instantly with all my heart.
Antonio, I married from an excuse to me as life itself, but life itself, my wife, the whole world, and work to me as your wife.
Your wife wouldn't like it if she were here. Did you make that offer?
I have a wife I love. I wish she were in heaven, so she could appeal to some power to make this dull, cheap change of mind.
It's nice you're offering to sacrifice your man in bed. Yeah, we should go to start pointing our people in the
head. That's what you get for marrying Christian.
Christian husband. I have a daughter, and I wish she had married any of Barabbas' descendants instead of Christian. We're wasting time. I urge you to deliver your sentence. What a righteous judge.
Wait a minute, Jude. This contract doesn't give you any blood at all. The words expressly specify a pound of flesh. So take your penalty of a pound of flesh. But if you shed one drop of Christian blood when you shed it, your land and property will be confiscated under Venetian law.
In that case, I'll take up your offer. Pay me the 3,000 ducats and let the Christian go.
Yes, I am ready.
Wait, the Jew will have justice. Wait, don't rush. He's not getting anything except the penalty.
Oh, what an upright judge. Pay attention, Jew. Oh, what a wise judge.
You beat my money and let me go.
You can't have anything but the penalty to be taken at your peril, Jew.
Well then, I hope he chokes on it. I'm not standing here to argue anymore.
Wait a minute, Jew. The law has yet another hold on you. The law of the Venice state is before a president, directly or indirectly, attempts to kill a citizen. His land and property will be confiscated under the Venetian law. Whether the offending person lives or dies is up to the Jew. There is no one else to appeal to. In your predicament, you earn that punishment because you clearly contrived, directly and indirectly too, to take the life of the offender. So get down on your knees and beg mercy from the Jew.
Beg to be allowed to hang yourself. But if you handed over all your wealth to the state, you won't even have a rope to buy. Just so you'll be hanged at the state's expense.
I want you to see the difference between you, so I pardon you even before you ask for pardon. Half of your wealth goes to Antonio, the other half goes to the state. But if you show a proper humility, I can use the penalty to apply.
Yes, the state's half can be reduced, but not Antonio's.
No, go ahead. You take my life away when you take away the means of upkeep. You take my house away when you take away the means of making a living.
What mercy can you show me, Antonio?
If the court agrees to set aside the fine to just one half of his property, I'm happy, as long as he lets me have the other half in trust to give to the gentleman who stole his daughter. I only ask two things from him. First, he must immediately become a Christian. Secondly, he must make a will in this court to leave all his property behind to his son-in-law Lorenzo and to his daughter when he dies.
Are you satisfied, Jew?
What do you think?
I'm satisfied.
Clerk, draw up a document to make this gift official.
Please let me go. I'm not feeling well. Send the deed after me and I'll sign it then.
Go. When you're baptized a Christian, you will have two godfathers. If I were to be judge, I would have sentenced you. I would have given you 10, 11 more to sentence you to death.
Sir, please don't hold me.
I'm very sorry, sir, but I have to leave for Padua tonight. I should really leave right away.
I'm sorry, Mr. Father. Antonio, give the gentleman his word. In my opinion, he owes you a lot.
Yes, sir.